You're listening to The Hub on Art. My name's Ed Ez, and the producer Wendy Love joins me now. Wendy, what's happening? Why are you in the studio?
Well, I went on a guided tour at the Queensland Art Gallery recently, and it wasn't your typical art tour.
Oh, so what was different?
Well, you know how art, whether it's a movie, a song, a painting, it can really affect us on a visceral level. Like, it can trigger emotions or feelings from the past we haven't felt for a while, or even just make us feel more connected to something from another time. Well, this tour I went on really harnesses that power to reach people living with dementia. It's a tailor-made guided talk that helps foster communication and draws out the personalities of people with dementia. And did you know that nearly 1 in 10 Australians over 65 have dementia?
Wow, I did not. But Wendy, this sounds like a really positive social experience in a way.
Yeah, it is. And it really boosts their mood and confidence. And it gives them and their partners and carers the opportunity to get in touch with their creative sides. And the power of the artworks also seemed to unlock their ability to communicate. So it's really special.
Yeah, thank you so much, Wendy. And let's go on the tour.
Alrighty, so here we are at the Queensland Art Gallery, and we are going to follow Sheila. Sheila's going to show us one of our very first paintings. So we're going to
We just finished morning tea in the outdoor courtyard, and Debbie Britton is welcoming us to the gallery. She's a project manager at the Queensland Art Gallery and the Gallery of Modern Art here in Brisbane. She helped develop the Art in Dementia program in 2014, which is evidence-based and tailored specifically for people living with dementia.
I do put a lot of thought into the artworks that are specially selected, so it can vary. Absolutely, it's about the environment where the artwork is hanging, so I need to ensure that it's at correct height on the wall for the visual opportunity for people with dementia to be able to see at their eye level rather than too high or too low, the size of the work, if there's any glare. I try to look for artworks with lovely contrast, but at the same time that aren't too busy. We know, research tells us, that people with dementia can see red very well, blue, yellows. So that's not always a criteria, but I find if an artwork has got those colours in it, it does really tend to engage those with dementia more fully.
Debbie knows the power art has to unlock the imagination, to elicit memories, to spark new ideas and discussions. And for people living with dementia and their care partners, this offers a new space to connect, not only to the artwork, but to each other.
The format of the tour really puts the people with dementia in the driving seat in terms of conversation, that we'll always be able to dig up something, whether it's a hobby or maybe childhood memories. If we know someone's previous career or interests, we can generally, you know, find some sort of a link there as well. And that makes a really joyful experience, not only for those with dementia, but certainly their care partners, who find that they're hearing stories that they may not have been hearing for a very long time, or even possibly learning something new about their partner that they didn't even know about.
Our volunteer guide for the morning is Sheila, who's trained in leading gallery tours for people with dementia. She walks us through the gallery to find the first of two paintings we'll view on this month's tour. And as we walk, I meet two of the program's participants, Leanne and her husband, Greg. They've been coming together for nearly a year.
I think, Greg, you become more alive in seeing the paintings.
Greg was diagnosed with dementia in 2015. He's 70 now. But Leanne knew something was up a few years before, when he began stumbling over his words during talks he'd give on environmental science. Coming along to the gallery with a dementia-friendly group allows them to experience their love of art together, to connect the landscapes, the colors they see, with the places they've traveled to in the past.
What do you like about it?
Oh, really, it's... I love it. good art, and some and wouldn't see them in the other.
You wouldn't see them if it weren't for coming to this.
Really.
The dozen or so participants take a seat in front of Morning Ride by the very well-known Australian watercolorist, Kenneth McQueen. It's a depiction of a paddock in the Darling Downs, three kangaroos hopping through eucalyptus trees, a maple brown horse.
What's the first thing that you noticed, Greg?
I've seen it before.
You've seen it before?
Yeah.
And what's the first thing that you notice when you look at it?
The
sweep? So he sees the sweep?
Of the
Yes. Yeah. So there's a beautiful sweep. Yeah. Across the artwork?
Yeah.
The
program's been so valuable for Greg, something to look forward to when they really encourage the people with dementia to talk and draw them out, and they're all so kind, and he really looks forward to it, which is really good. Good break.
We spend a good 15 minutes or so with Morning Ride. Sheila takes plenty of time to ask the group for their thoughts as they warm up and get comfortable and a bit more verbal. I meet Lisa, a lifestyle coordinator at an aged care facility. She's here as a chaperone.
I've seen people over the years that have come and they've been quite shy and they've opened up every time they sit in front of a specific art piece that is familiar to them. I've seen some residents really express their thoughts about the art every time we come here and talk about it with their families as well after the tour. So I found specifically the colours is what brightens them up more. When we look at art with a lot of colour, they're able to express more.
We move on to another room in the gallery, one that's a little bit noisier. We take our seats in front of a very colorful and very famous oil painting, Charles Blackman's The Blue Alice. And Lisa is right. The group is definitely responding to the vibrant hues.
And we're going to look at the work. And again, I want you to think what
I creep up to Barbara, who's in the early stages of dementia. She's studying the painting quite intently, its blue background, Alice surrounded by white daisies, the white rabbit with its big eye looking right at us.
White mouse, dormouse there.
What do you think of this one? Very busy, very, very hard to do the amount of colour in it. Oh, the white outstanding on the flowers is just so busy. That would take hours and hours. Wouldn't take probably him hours and hours, it would take me hours and hours to do. But it's very well done, though. To get everything in that sort of perspective, you know. I think the rabbit's got big ears. His ears are a bit long. But I think, you know, she's got the bunch of flowers there and it's just beautiful.
Now, Alice has closed eyes. So really...
Here, the guide is drawing the group's attention to the rabbit in the painting and Alice, pointing out that Alice's eyes are closed, which is meant to be a reference to Charles Blackman's wife with her failing eyesight. And the rabbit with its large eye is Charles, the seeing side of the relationship.
He saw and she was led by him. It's a beautiful comment on their relationship.
Just at this moment, one of the men in the group who's standing at the back listening attentively puts his hand on his wife's shoulder, who has younger onset dementia. She's seated in front of him, and he gives her this heartfelt squeeze, as if acknowledging the connection between Alice and the white rabbit and his relationship with his own wife. The tour wraps up and the group heads over to a few tables set with plenty of art supplies, paintbrushes, watercolors, pencils, fresh flowers, and small printouts of the paintings they saw today to inspire them to create their own artworks. This way they not only view art, but make art that they can reflect on later.
It's really special. When you're focusing on the art, there's nothing else. You're just in that moment.
Yeah.
Whereas at home, you know, you're thinking of all other things you should be doing or whatever, but you're here for that dedicated hour and that's it.
Hub on Art producer Wendy Love at the Queensland Art Gallery in Brisbane. Please visit our website for more information on this programme, and there are free tours like this at galleries and museums all around Australia, at the NGA in Canberra, the MCA in Sydney, in regional centres as well. And if you or a relative or a friend is living with dementia, you can call around to art spaces in your area to see what programmes they're offering as well. It could bring a new, brighter dimension to their lives.